Hello friends. Today I want to look at a simplest way of calculating for gamma using the calculator. In calculating for the value of gamma, we need to take note of the general equations that have been given unto us in gamma in our calculus lessons. The first identity I wanted to look at is that gamma of n is equal to the integral of 0 to infinity of x to the power n minus 1 multiplying by e to the power negative x with respect to dx, where n is positive. Note that x or integral of x or n is always with respect to x. So when you pick your calculator, you realize that it's always with respect to dx. The second identity I want us to look at is gamma of n is equal to the gamma of n plus 1 all on n. And you have to know this identity also. That is when we cannot exactly find half, the gamma of half in our question. So we're going to use this one. Now, the next identity, which is the third identity, is taking, I want to just correct this. This is n and not a. Let's take note of that. And the third identity is n, gamma of n plus 1 is equal to n factorial. So I take the factorial of n and that will give me the result. And the fourth identity I want us to take note of is gamma of n can be expressed as n gamma of n, which is equal to n in bracket n minus 1 bracket close gamma of n minus 2 in that series. So it means that when I know the gamma of half and I've been given gamma of 0.5, which is as half, I can easily express as root pi. But in the case where I've been given something more than half, which is 1.5, an example below, that's 1.5, is equal to 3 on 2. I can express as 3 on 2 minus 1, which is half, and then gamma of 3 on 2 minus 1, which is also half, and I know my half, so I just fix gamma of half inside, which is root pi, and I'll have my answer as, so that is, gamma of half is pi, and I take pi times, sorry, root pi times half, which give me root pi on 2. Now, let us get our calculator and kick going. So, I have my calculator over here. Hope you can all see the calculator. No, you cannot see it. So, let the calculator come over here. Okay. This is a Casio calculator. I want us to look at it very well. Now, I want to find the gamma of 3, which we know it should be what? 2 factorial. That is n, you have to express 3 as n plus 1. So when I express 3 as n plus 1, it means that n will be 2 plus 1. And then my n will be 2. So I take 2 factorial. Let me clear my calculator. So I'll just take 2, shift, then x to the power negative 1, and I get my factorial, hit your equal sign, and the answer will give you is 2. And also, the second question is 8, gamma of 8, and so gamma of 8 is also expressed as 7 plus 1, so therefore my n is 7. And so I type in my calculator, 7, shift, x to the power negative 1, then my equal to, and that will give me the answer correctly. Now let's look at the question 3, which has been in our assignment given unto us, but this one is also in the form of the equation given unto us. This is what is given unto us. So I know my n here is n minus 1 is 4.
So I equate n minus 1 to 4 and find the value of n. And when I find the value of n, you realize that I will have 5. So it means I'm going to find gamma of 5. But gamma of 5, we know, is n plus 1, where my n is 5. Okay, so I take 4 plus 1 would be equal to 4 factorial. So I type in 4 factorial on my calculator. 4 factorial. And hit the equal sign. That is 24. Now, this is a real number and a whole number. So what if we have been given a fraction? How do we deal with it? And in dealing with such cases, example as if question 4, we have gamma of 5.5. In that case, we got to utilize the equation given twice. We have to utilize it very well. So I am going to type in the equation on the calculator. Go and take your integral sign and type in x. So I take alpha of x to the power, that is x exponent that, n minus 1. And here n minus 1, and my n I know is 5.5. So 5.5 minus 1. So 5.5 minus 1 is going to be 4.5. Just put it directly, or if you want, you can put it in a bracket. So what I mean is that I can also type 5.5 minus 1. Put the whole thing in a bracket. But it is easy way, I do it this way. Now I hit this arrow sign, and I type E. So I get alpha, then 10 exponent negative, so negative x, then hit the arrow sign again, it will send it to the base of the integral, and we know it's from 0 to infinity. Now I want you to note this: infinity sign is not on the calculator, therefore I will use an approximate figure. So let's say 100, 250, 1000. But the higher your figure, the higher your, the time your calculator will take to calculate it. So therefore, I will just limit myself to 100, and that one will be good. So hit the arrow key again, so, and hit your 100 inside. Now press the equal sign. Bam. Let's wait about a minute, and there our answer will appear. Very easy and simple. Alright, so here is our answer: 52.342778, which is what is given on towards here. And now let's say in objective seek, you have been given 94.5 root pi all over 32. You can just test this and see whether I will get this. Okay. And that is our answer for gamma of 5.5. Now, when I come to, so the next example is 3.5. That is gamma of 3.5. Let's key in 3.5 on the calculator, then we see our result. 3.5, which is n minus 3.5. And n minus 3.5, so 3.5 minus 1 is going to be 2.5. So I key in my credentials. So I don't want to clean the thing on the calculator, so I just hit the back arrow key and it will send me there to where I want. So I continue hitting to where I want to alter the change. So this is where I want to alter the change. I only want to change the 4 to 2. So I hit the delete button and hit my 2. Bam. Then I hit the equal sign. and wait for the result to come. So my result is 3.32335094, and that is what we have gotten over here. So I can write, let me write the result down. Okay, here we go, the answer is over there. Now the next example is saying we find the gamma of 6.5. in the same procedure, hit the back arrow key because I want to change only one of them, and so I don't need to type the whole thing again. So continue to hit until I get to 2, then I remove the 2 using the delete key, and I enter my 6, then hit the equal sign, wait for it to come. So at least it will take a time before it comes, so wait patiently, don't hit any button, and here is our result. Shim. Now, you've seen that this result is different from what we will be expecting, because what I have kept here is 6.5, which means I'm calculating gamma of 7.5. Take note. So the moment you make a mistake and key in that same thing, you're going to get a different result. Our equation is n minus 1, so, and I'm looking for that. So that means I should have taken this minus 1. Hope you understand it. And so therefore, let's come back and put the writing. I just did this so that we can get the understanding of what I mean. So it means we are looking for 5.5 and not 6. Okay, hit the equal sign and let's see what happens. Alright. Just a few seconds. And there, our result goes. So that is the result over there. So gamma of 6.5 is 287.8852778. So that is the result for us. Now we got to look at the 7, the final one is saying that we find gamma of 3.5. Sorry, I think this is get a mistake, man. There is a mistake here, man. Yeah, I know that. Okay, mistake rectified. So this is what we are looking for, but not gamma of 3.5. So this is what we are going to calculate. Now we were able to calculate for 3.5, which is over here using the calculator, and we did 3, which is 2 factorial over here. And we did that, and our result is 2. And the result for this one is also lying over here. Now 6.5, which we just calculated. Now you factor everything inside, and you are going to get 16 on 693. Hope you enjoyed this video. So it's very easy to solve such questions with your calculator, and I recommend this calculator for you. If you need a calculator, you can contact me as well in Ghana here, UCC campus, and I'll get one for you. If you like this video, subscribe and share to bless a friend. You understand? Yeah, to bless a friend. And more videos will be coming. I'll be making another video on the beta functions and a lot of functions that we need to use the calculator to do. Calculator is to help us a lot. Like, subscribe, and share. Don't forget to make your comment so that I can improve on it. Thank you. Have a blessed day. Goodbye.